गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. हाउ आर यू ऑल?
मैम फाइन.
गुड. गुड.
फाइन मैम.
ओके. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू अ न्यू चैप्टर. वी हैव डन दैट चैप्टर. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द क्वेश्चन आंसर.
मैम यस मैम एंड आंसर इन डिटेल आल्सो वी हैव डन.
The previous class was about these dictation words. So we've completed those dictation words also.
Yes, ma'am. 30 words are there.
30 yes, words. Ma'am. Did we check those 30 words?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
No, ma'am.
What was your score, children? Did you check your score?
Yes, ma'am, I got full.
Ma'am, I also got full.
Ma'am, my two was wrong.
Ma'am, I got 29.
Okay, Rayansh, what is the spelling of lieutenant?
Ma'am, I-E-U-T-E-N-A-N.
Very nice, lieutenant. This is the toughest one. All right. What is the spelling of receive? Summer. What is the spelling of receive?
Ma'am, R E C I E V E.
Wrong. It's R E C E I V E. R E C E I V E. Okay, Anjali Saxena, what is the spelling of perennial?
Ma'am, P E R R.
Wrong. Pratyusha Singh, what is the spelling of perennial? Put your cameras on, children, hurry up.
Spelling of perennial is P E R E N N I A L.
Okay, very nice. Vedant, what is the spelling of poultry?
Ma'am, what?
What is the spelling of poultry? Poultry farm.
Poultry.
Yes.
P O L.
Okay.
T R E E.
Wrong.
Iman.
Ma'am.
Iman, what is the spelling of poultry? Unmute yourself, Iman.
Yes, ma'am.
Hurry up and tell. Don't look into the book.
Yeah, but
your own.
Ma'am, can I tell? Ma'am.
Okay, Summer, tell the spelling of alluvial.
Ma'am, what?
Alluvial. Alluvial.
A double L U V I A L.
Very good. Very nice. Imad, what happened? You don't know?
Ma'am, can I tell the spelling of poultry also?
No. Okay. Pratishtha, tell the spelling of Baisakhi. No, wrong. Who will tell the spelling of Baisakhi? Rayansh.
Ma'am, B-A-I-S-A-K-H-I.
Very nice. It's B-A-I. Okay. What is the spelling of governor? Governor. What is the spelling of governor?
Imad.
Imad, I want to hear from you. Beta, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am. G O V E R N E R.
N-E-R, wrong. It's not N-E-R. It's N-O-R. Governor. N-O-R. Okay, who will tell the spelling of Devyanshu Dev? Are you there? Devyanshu Dev. He is not there. Om Agarwal, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Om Agarwal will tell the spelling of embroidery. Embroidery.
Ma'am, A-M-R-O-I-D-R-Y.
A-M?
A-M-R-O.
Mehul, Mehul, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell the spelling of embroidery.
Embroidery. The spelling of embroidery, E-M-E-R-I-D-E.
No, you really need to work on spellings. This is social studies. It has so many difficult words. See, you will lose so many marks when you start writing. Pratyusha, yes, tell.
E-M-B-R-O-I-D-E-R-Y.
Very good. It's embroidery. Okay. Now, what is the spelling?
Her notebook.
Yes, ma'am.
But she has written it herself, no, yesterday. Okay, Pratyusha, can you tell the spellings of engineering without looking into your copy?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, close your copy. First, close your copy. Yes, now tell.
E-N-G-I-N-E-E-R-I-N-G.
Very nice. Very good. See, Summer? She can say it like that also. Okay, Ridhyansh. Ridhyansh Saxena has just entered the class. Ridhyansh, can you tell us the spellings of industrial?
I-N-D-I-S-T-U-R-I-A-L.
Once again, beta.
I-N-D-I-A-S-T-U-R-I-A-L.
No, Ridhyansh, no. This is not the spelling of industrial. Okay, can you tell, Ridhyansh, can you tell the spelling of delicious?
D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S.
Very nice. Delicious is correct. Industrial. I-N-D-U-S.
Okay,
industrial. P-R-I-A-L. Okay, what is the spelling of parliament? Om Agarwal, can you tell the spelling of parliament?
Ma'am, P-A-R-L-A-M-E-N-T.
P-A-R-L-A. It's parlia. Parliament.
P-A-R-L-E-Y-M-E-N-T.
No, Om. Beta, start learning these spellings. Vedant. Vedant Namami. Vedant, are you there? Can you tell the spelling of parliament? Now look.
Ma'am.
How you are taking your class. Look at your posture.
P-A-R-L-I-A-M-E-N-T.
That's correct. Now, should I click a picture of yours? Vedant, is this how you're supposed to be in the class? Huh? Lying on the bed. Get up and sit like Rayansh, Pratyusha, Om, Summer. See, how is everybody sitting? You're lying on the bed. Set your camera and show me your face. Set your camera towards your face. I can't see your face. Yes. Good. Now that's the way. Okay. Then, what is the spelling of commerce? Commerce. Imad, you haven't told me even a single correct spelling. What is the spelling of commerce?
Ma'am, C-O-M. E-R-C-E, commerce.
Okay, C-O-M-M. It's C-O-M-M-E-R-C-E, commerce. Okay? All right. So children, you really need to work hard on spellings because these words are very difficult, like Victoria Memorial, Havra Bridge, and then we have this Jamia Millia Islamia. Did I tell this word yesterday in dictation?
Yes,
Humayun's tomb.
And ma'am, embroidery spelling also.
Embroidery, Humayun's tomb. We have so many difficult words. When you start writing your answers in next class, you will face a real big difficulty that time.
Ma'am,
so start
I know
learning. Work on spellings also.
Ma'am, I know the spelling of Jamia, Malia, and Islamia.
Okay, tell. Ma'am, Imad is going to tell.
Ma'am, J-A-M-I-A, Jamia.
Yes.
M-A-I-A, Malia.
No, Peter. It's not Malia, it's Milia. Jamia, Milia, Islamia.
M-I-L-L-I-A, Milia.
M-I-L-L-I-A. M-I-L-L, Milia.
I-S-L-A-M-I-A, Islamia.
Very good. I-S-L-A-M-I-A, Islamia. Good. Now, shall we move to the next chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Ready to begin? The next
yes, ma'am.
Chapter. Okay, everybody open up your books to page number 111.
I have read this chapter tomorrow. I mean yesterday.
What? You did this chapter yesterday?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. You read it on your own?
Yes, ma'am.
Very nice. Very good. Now, who will start reading? I want Vedant to start.
Can I?
Vedant? Start reading like this. Chapter 17, name of the chapter, and then begin.
Chapter 17, the Peninsular Regions and the Islands. Let's learn about the Southern Plateau and Island Regions, life in the states of the region. The Peninsular Region. The Peninsular Region, the Peninsular Plateau of India or the Southern Plateau is divided into two parts of the, by the valley formed by the river Narmada, the Malwa Plateau and the Chota Nagpur Plateau.
Chota
the Malwa
Nagpur.
Plateau is
Chota Nagpur
located
Plateau.
In the north. Chota Nagpur Plateau. The Malwa Plateau is located in the northwest and the Chota Nagpur Plateau is located in the northern northeast of the Peninsular Plateau. The Malwa Plateau lies between the Aravalli and Vindhya Mountain ranges. The parts of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh lie in this region. The rivers Chambal, Son, and Damodar flow through this region. The Chota
Plateau
comprises.
That's all. Now, can you see, children, can you see this map given, this picture given, half India? So we have this central India and southern India. Beta, page number 111. Page number 111, chapter 17. Okay. So we see the central India till the southern India. We don't see the northern part of India here. Why? Because the northern mountain region and the northeastern belt we have already studied. Now what we are studying? We are studying the peninsular region. The peninsular region starts from the place which is shown in the map. Okay? So we study that the peninsular region starts from where parts of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh lie in this region. In which region? In the Malwa Plateau region. The peninsular region is divided into two parts. Which are those two parts? The Malwa Plateau and the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Right? Just underline
yes,
this line. The peninsular region is divided into two parts. Then the Malwa Plateau. Where does Malwa Plateau start from? It starts from the parts of Rajasthan. And two, it comes down to Madhya Pradesh. Then we have, yes?
Please repeat again. Yes. What we have to underline?
Ma'am, what we are doing, can you tell us? Because ma'am, I am late.
Adrika, you are too late, beta. You are too late. 15 minutes late. Now see how much you must have. Yes, see how much how much you must have missed. All right, we are doing chapter 17, page number 111.
Okay.
Divyanshu, which line you have to underline? You have to underline that the peninsular plateau of India is divided into two parts. Now, what are those two parts? The Malwa Plateau and the Chota Nagpur Plateau. The Malwa Plateau lies between the Aravali and the Vindhya mountain range. Which state? The parts of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh lie in the Malwa Plateau region. And when we move eastwards towards the Chota Nagpur Plateau, we have the states of Jharkhand and some parts of Odisha, Bihar and Chhattisgarh. Which states fall under Malwa Plateau? Tell me. Parts of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh.
And which states? Jharkhand and some parts of Odisha, Bihar and Chhattisgarh.
They are in the Chota Nagpur Plateau. I am talking about the Malwa Plateau.
Ma'am, Madhya Pradesh and some parts of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh.
Yes, Malwa Plateau is on the west hand side, children. You have to remember this thing. Malwa Plateau is on the western side, and Chota Nagpur Plateau is on the eastern side. So the western states are what? Rajasthan, right? This plateau starts from Rajasthan and it comes down to Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh is the central part of India. Then from there, the Chota Nagpur Plateau starts and it moves eastwards. Which states fall under that region? The states of Chota Nagpur Plateau are Jharkhand.
Ma'am, Jharkhand, some parts of Odisha, Bihar, and Chhattisgarh.
Yes. Then the Deccan Plateau lies to the south of Satpura Range. Now, all the states that lie in the southern part come under the Deccan Plateau. Okay? You have to be very clear in your mind. Which states fall under Malwa Plateau? Which states come under Chota Nagpur Plateau? And all the states that remain in the south are a part of Deccan Plateau. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Then, next, who will read? Adrika will read. The Chota Nagpur Plateau.
The Chota Nagpur Plateau comprise Jharkhand and some parts of Odisha, Bihar and Chhattisgarh. The Deccan Plateau lies to the south of the Satpura Range. It comprises parts of Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. The rivers Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna flow through the Deccan Plateau. The Kaveri River flows from the west to east into the Bay of Bengal. The Tapi and Narmada flow westwards into the Arabian Sea.
All right. So now when we look at the Deccan Plateau, we see which states come under Deccan Plateau? The states of Chhattisgarh, Odisha,
Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana.
Children, do you have a pencil in your hand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, on page number 111, write all the states that fall under Deccan Plateau. On those states, just write DP. DP stands for Deccan Plateau. Okay?
Okay,
MP. MP stands for Malwa Plateau. And CNP, Chota Nagpur Plateau. Just write on these states. Read from the passage.
Ma'am, what we have to do? Repeat again. Your voice is not coming to me.
Okay. You can see this map given on page number 111.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I have done.
Half yes, map of India. Just wait. Those who have done, please don't disturb in between. Then, the states that lie in the Deccan Plateau. You have to write DP on those states. Suppose, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu are a part of which plateau? Deccan Plateau. Just write DP in this state. That this is a part of Deccan Plateau.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Jharkhand is a part of Chota Nagpur Plateau. Write CNP. Chota Nagpur Plateau. CNP.
I'm first time writing of Deccan Plateau.
Yes. Write this thing so that it becomes clear in your mind.
I'm written.
See, Orissa and Bihar are a part of Chota Nagpur also, but the southern part of Bihar and Orissa. Southern part of Orissa comes under what? Deccan Plateau. Beta, Bihar is only a part of Chota Nagpur. It is not a part of Deccan Plateau. Orissa is a part of both the plateaus. Why? Because the northern part falls under Chota Nagpur and the southern falls under Deccan Plateau. Vedant is just on with his stunts. Practicing different stunts here and there.
Deccan Plateau.
Where is Orissa? I cannot see the Orissa.
Purple color. See? Purple color right hand side. It's Orissa.
Okay, ma'am, I found it. Thank you, ma'am. And so, ma'am, on Orissa, we have to write.
See, on the northern part of Orissa, the upper part of Orissa is the Chota Nagpur Plateau. The lower part is the DP, Deccan Plateau.
Okay, ma'am.
DP, MP, CNP. Okay, remember this thing.
Ma'am, the upper part of Chhattisgarh lies in the Chota Nagpur Plateau.
Yes, beta, yes.
Ma'am. Ma'am, I have marked Deccan Plateau and Chota Nagpur Plateau.
Yes. Now, Malwa Plateau has got just two states. Some parts of Rajasthan and...
Ma'am, I've done the exercises.
Madhya Pradesh.
Ma'am, where is Rajasthan? Ma'am, where is Rajasthan?
Beta, Rajasthan is not written here, but can you see this portion? The left-hand side of Madhya Pradesh. The left, just on the left-hand side where it's written Tropic of Cancer is the state of Gujarat. Now, just above Gujarat lies Rajasthan. That is Rajasthan. Okay?
Okay. The orange color part.
Yes?
Ma'am, the violet color part.
Beta, I can't understand what you are saying.
Ma'am, Pratyusha is saying orange color part.
No, beta, why orange? I am saying on the left-hand side of Madhya Pradesh. Can you see this Tropic of Cancer written? Left hand side of Madhya Pradesh.
No, ma'am, in my book there is not written.
Ma'am, in mine also.
Let me share this picture with you all. What is in your, show me what is in your book. Just send it to me on my personal number.
Ma'am, let me send. Okay, ma'am, wait a minute.
I'm also sending to you people.
Now.
Yes, now. Send it on the class group. Send it on the class group.
Okay, ma'am. I'm just a minute. I'm sending.
Okay, in your book it's given orange color. In my book it is given white color. So yes, the orange part is the Rajasthan, the parts of Rajasthan. That comes under which Malwa Plateau? Can you see what I have shared in the class group?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Oops. So yes, this orange part is what? Malwa Plateau and some the Madhya Pradesh.
I'm done. Mama, I have shared you.
Mama, I have done.
Okay, children. Now you have marked all of them?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let's move ahead. Who is going to read?
Ma'am.
Ma'am, can I close my video for a minute? Ma'am, can I close my video for a minute?
Yes, close.
Ma'am, can I read?
Yes, Summer. Summer, read out the next one.
Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh is a state located in central India. Bhopal is its capital city. Gwalior, Indore, and Jabalpur are other important cities of Madhya Pradesh. The Pachmarhi Hill Station, Kanha Tiger Reserve, and Bandhavgarh National Park are some of the places of interest in Madhya Pradesh. The temples of Khajuraho are important monuments. The diamond mines at Kanha are also located here. Cotton and wheat are the important crops cultivated here.
Okay, so this was about Madhya Pradesh. Where is Madhya Pradesh located? It is located
in central India.
And that is why it has been named so. What does Madhya means? Madhya means the center, right? So it is, when we look at the map of India, it is the centermost state of India. Then, what is the capital of this place?
Ma'am, Bhopal.
Yes, very nice. And Gwalior, Indore, and Jabalpur are other important towns of Madhya Pradesh.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, my father has visited to Gwalior.
All right. Very nice. So we have the diamond mines. Where are the diamond mines located in Madhya Pradesh?
In a place
called Panna.
Which is called Panna.
And what are the important crops that are cultivated here?
Ma'am, cotton and wheat.
So this is all about Madhya Pradesh. Then coming on to Chhattisgarh. Anjali Saxena, read out Chhattisgarh.
Ma'am, we don't have to underline anything in Madhya Pradesh.
No, you don't have to write. Underline, you're asking underline.
Yes, ma'am.
Underline all the important lines, all the important points that I have discussed. It is the centralmost state. Bhopal is its capital. Then the diamond mines are at Panna. Cotton and wheat are important crops. And also underline the Kanha Tiger Reserve and Bandhavgarh National Park are some places of interest. Ma'am. Done?
Yes, ma'am, done.
Yes, ma'am,
yes, ma'am. Okay. Done.
Anjali Saxena, read out the next one.
Chhattisgarh is located in East Central India. Jaipur is its capital city. This state is mainly located along the Mahanadi River basin. The source of the Mahanadi River is near Jaipur. Chhattisgarh has a varied landscape with many valleys. Indravati, Alpa, and Taivi are some of the important rivers. The state experiences hot, dry, and windy summer and heavy rainfall during the rainy season. The state is rich in minerals such as coal, iron, and ma'am, what is written after iron?
Bauxite.
Mining, agriculture, energy production, and manufacturing are the main industries of Chhattisgarh. The Bihalai steel plant that produces steel rails is located in Bihalai. In Chhattisgarh, the major crops grown here are rice and maize.
Okay. So when we study about the state of Chhattisgarh, we have, it is the now, what is it? Like Madhya Pradesh is the central state of India. It is the
Eastern Central.
Then what is the capital of this place? It's
Raipur. Ma'am, Jaipur.
Raipur, not Jaipur.
Ma'am, Raipur only.
Okay. I heard Jaipur. Then what do we have? This state is, now which line you have to underline? This state is rich in minerals. Which all minerals? Coal, iron, and bauxite.
Ma'am, what is bauxite?
Beta, one of the minerals, even I don't know much about it, which mineral it is.
I'm underlined.
Underlined?
I'm done.
Yes, wait, ma'am.
Okay. Then we have the Bhilai steel plant. Have you heard of the Bhilai steel plant?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. It is the biggest steel plant of India. The biggest producers of India in steel. The biggest steel producer, you can say, that is the Bhilai. The Bhilai steel plant is located where? It is located in a place called Bhilai, which is in Chhattisgarh. Okay? That's all about this place. Now, next, who will read out? Yes?
Ma'am, the Bhilai steel line, we have to underline.
Yes, you have to underline.
Okay. Ma'am, now can I read? Ma'am, now yes, can I?
Okay, now let's have Pratyusha. Pratyusha, read out Jharkhand.
Jharkhand. Jharkhand is located in the northeastern part of India. Ranchi is its capital. It has curved out of Bihar in the year 2000. Most of Jharkhand falls under the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Jharkhand is almost entirely covered by plateaus, hills, and valleys. The two main plateaus are. Ma'am, what is written this after R?
Hazaribagh. The two main plateaus are Hazaribagh and Ranchi.
They are separated by a river,
Damodar.
Brahmi and the Sun are the other river that run through the state. Jharkhand has a huge forest cover. Jamshedpur, Dokra, and Ranchi are some of important industrial towns of Jharkhand. They are known for steel production. The state also has a flourishing agriculture sector. Ahmedabad is also an important city in this state.
All right. Now, Jharkhand is in the northeastern part of India. What is the capital of Jharkhand?
Ma'am, Ranchi.
Ranchi. And Jharkhand was a part of which state? Before being an independent state, it was a part of which state?
Bihar.
Jharkhand was a part of Bihar. It was in year 2000 that it was carved out of Bihar. Then, most of Jharkhand falls under the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Then, the two main plateaus of Jharkhand are the
Hazaribagh and Ranchi.
And Ranchi Plateau. These are the two main plateaus of Jharkhand. Jharkhand has a huge forest cover. What are some of the important industrial towns of Jharkhand?
Ma'am, Ranchi, Bokaro,
and
Jamshedpur. Ma'am,
Jamshedpur, Bokaro, and Ranchi are the important industrial towns of Jharkhand. That means we have many industries located in these places of Jharkhand. They are known for steel production. What are these industries known for?
Yes, ma'am.
They are known for their
steel production.
And then we study that Dhanbad is also an important state. Oh, sorry, important city in the state. Coming on to Orissa. Now,
ma'am, what do we have to align in this Jharkhand?
What are some important industrial towns of Jharkhand, which are known for steel production? Then the two main plateaus of Jharkhand, Hazaribagh and Ranchi. And these two plateaus are separated by what? They are separated by River Damodar.
Okay,
and one very important thing that Jharkhand was carved out of Bihar in year 2000. Okay.
Ma'am, we have to underline this also. It is carved out by Bihar in this year.
Yes. It is a very important line. Done?
Yes, ma'am. Done.
All right. Now, yes, coming on to the state of Odisha.
Ma'am, can I read?
Riyansh. Okay, Riyansh will read.
Odisha. Odisha is located in northeastern India. Bhubaneswar is its capital city. Cuttack and Puri are the other big towns. Paradip is the port. The famous Jagannath temple is in Puri, where the annual Rath Yatra is held. Odisha is known for its silver work called filigree and textiles. Rice and jute are the main crops grown. The Hirakud Dam is built on the Mahanadi River that flows through the state. The classical dance Odissi belongs to this state. Lake Chilka, a home of migratory birds, lies along the coastal plain.
Okay. So, what is the capital of Bhubaneswar? Sorry, what is the capital of Orissa?
Bhubaneswar.
That's Bhubaneswar.
Ma'am, Bhubaneswar.
Yes. And then we have this famous Jagannath temple that lies in the state of Orissa. Then also, children, you have to underline this very important line. Orissa is known for its silver work called filigree. Orissa is famous for its silver work called filigree. Okay. And Hirakud Dam is